People's Republic of China, Wang Qishan. Welcome to Jerusalem, and thank you all for taking part in the fourth meeting of the China-Israel Joint Committee on Innovation Cooperation, JCIC. JCIC, ladies and gentlemen, was established in 2014 and convened on an annual basis, alternately in Beijing and Jerusalem. This year, JCIC is co-chaired by Israel's Prime Minister and Minister of Foreign Affairs, Benjamin Netanyahu, and China's Vice President, Wang Qishan. China-Israel, JCIC, has become an important G2G platform which promotes innovation cooperation in various fields and encompasses 13 ministries and government agencies from the two countries, as well as leading higher education and research institutions. Ladies and gentlemen, for opening remarks, please welcome Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu.
Vice President Wang Qishan, distinguished ministers and colleagues from China and from Israel, welcome to Jerusalem. I'm delighted to host the fourth meeting of the China-Israel Joint Committee on Innovation Cooperation here in Israel. Last year in Beijing, President Xi Jinping and I agreed to an innovative, comprehensive partnership to boost innovation cooperation between our two countries. I believe that the appointment of Vice President Qishan as co-chair of this committee and his visit to Israel reflects the growing importance of this partnership. It also reflects the growing ties between our countries, our economies, our peoples. The partnership between China and Israel is a natural partnership. There's a natural affinity, and a natural friendship between the ancient people of China and the ancient people of Israel. We're both rooted in great traditions. In fact, the other night, in a wonderful dinner, the Vice President and I discovered that we even like to read the same books about our great traditions. We're both rooted in a great respect for scholarship. We both strive for excellence. And this is the most important, we're both determined to seize the future. When we look at our histories, 5,000 years for China, 4,000 years for the Jewish people, then we see something incredible. We are very proud of our past, very conscious of our traditions, very connected to our homelands, but equally eager to develop new approaches that are not disconnected from our traditions. This is not obvious. Some people are sunk in the past. Some people seek only the future. We have two ancient civilizations that seize the future. And I think in many ways it explains the great successes of China and Israel. Now, we both realize that separately we can do great things, and we are doing great things. But I think together we can do even greater things. China is the second largest economy in the world, growing rapidly. Israel is among the leading innovation nations in the world. It's a global technological power. The sustained growth of both our countries and both our economies requires two things, which the Vice President spoke about just an hour ago. It requires innovation, and it requires scale. And it's the combination of the two that gives you the greatest effect and the greatest effectiveness. The combination of Israeli technology and innovation with Chinese industry, expertise, innovation, and markets is very powerful. When I visited China recently, President Xi couldn't emphasize more the importance he sees in innovation for China and the importance he sees in innovation for the Chinese-Israeli relationship. China is also Israel's second largest trade partner, reaching $10 billion in 2017, and it's already up 30% in 2018. I know for China this isn't the biggest trading partner. You're not laughing. But for us, it's very important. But I believe that we can get more from trade and from free trade, because free trade between us would accelerate joint ventures, would accelerate the recognition of mutual expertise by Israeli companies and their Chinese market partners. That's quite separate, but also added to the benefits of direct joint ventures, which we welcome, and I think are happening anyway. So I believe our cooperation has no limits. It extends to the fields of science, entrepreneurship, cultural exchanges, research, and more. And together we are unlocking massive potential. This is just the beginning. We will continue to unlock the potential of our nations by empowering Chinese and Israeli companies to expand their cooperation. The Vice President and I just saw an exhibit of some of these entrepreneurs and some of these technologists, and they are brilliant people. They already have partnerships with their Chinese counterparts, and I believe that we can have a lot more of this if we make it easy for Chinese companies to be here and for Israeli companies to be there. And there's much we can do. We discuss this. We discuss visas. We discuss flights, direct flights. There are already 50 such direct flights each week, but we can have many more. We, of course, welcome Chinese tourists. Mr. Vice President, we don't want more than 1% of China to visit Israel. I'm not sure the country is big enough. But we're very eager and very excited to expand this cooperation in every field. We believe that the number of Chinese investments in Israel can grow, and I think this is a win-win. The Israeli economy receives an influx of capital, expertise, and the ability to expand globally, to scale up globally. Chinese investors receive access to cutting-edge technologies, a talented pool of human capital, and very good returns. Chinese companies are already opening R&D centers throughout Israel, joining hundreds of other international companies. Choosing Israel is their innovation hub. And Chinese companies are also involved in dozens of strategic infrastructure projects in Israel. We discussed this at some length just now in our meeting. These projects include the construction of Israel's new ports, the Tel Aviv light rail, residential projects, the Carmel tunnels, and more. We want all of this to continue to grow. Today we'll sign a 3-year action plan. It's a detailed roadmap to increase our joint innovation efforts. And we will also continue our discussions to complete a free trade agreement, which I express my hope that we can complete by 2019. This will benefit everyone. We also will sign 8 joint agreements in science and technology, life sciences, innovation, digital health, and agriculture. There is not a single field of human endeavor that is not being changed by innovation and technology. Everything is being changed. We can live longer, we can live safer, healthier, better lives by allowing this expansion of technology and innovation. There is a natural partnership between us. We want to expand it for the benefit of both our peoples. We want to expand it for the benefit of all of humanity. And I think the field, the opportunities are vast. So I can only say that I welcome the opportunity to have these discussions with the Vice President, as I welcome the opportunity to have these discussions in my recent visit to China with President Xi Jinping. And I think we should continue this discussion as you suggested. Mr. Vice President, we have a traditional saying, the Jewish people have. We always say, next year in Jerusalem. We said this for thousands of years, next year in Jerusalem. Well, now I have a very small request. Next year in Beijing. Let's continue this. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Prime Minister Netanyahu. It is an honor to invite for opening remarks the Vice President of the People's Republic of China, Wang Qishan.
召开中以创新合作联委会第44会。刚才内塔尼亚胡总理做了热情洋溢的讲话，令我深受鼓舞。2017年，习近平主席和内塔尼亚胡总理共同确立了中以创新全面伙伴关系，为联委会工作指明了方向。本次会议的核心任务 就是要落实两国领导人达成的重要共识，就谋划和推动新时期两国创新合作进行深入探讨，努力取得更多互利共赢的成果。以色列是享誉世界的创新国度， 敢为人先，勤于思辨，勇于创新，宽容失败的创新文化，引领以色列走向了科技强国和科技富国的发展道路。创新是引领发展的第一动力，这一点在以色列得到了充分的体现。中国将创新放到新发展理念的首要位置，为建设现代化经济体系提供战略支撑。我们正努力通过技术创新、组织和制度的创新，动态平衡地处理好速度、结构、质量和效益的关系，加快建设创新型国家，实现经济从高速增长转向高质量的发展。近年来，中国科技创新能力显著增强，一些重要领域跻身世界先进行列，科技整体水平正处于从量的增长向质的提升转变。2017年，中国全社会研究与实验发展经费投入达到了1.76万亿元，占 GDP 比重已达到中等发达国家水平，取得了载人航天、载人深潜、超级计算、高速铁路等一系列重大科技成果。人工智能、云计算、大数据等创新技术广泛应用，引领数字经济快速发展，为经济发展注入了新的动能。中国将坚定不移走和平发展道路，通过深化改革、扩大开放，满足人民日益增长的美好生活需要。习近平主席提出的构建人类命运共同体和一带一路倡议顺应时代潮流，中国愿本着共商、共建、共享的理念，与世界各国共抓机遇，携手应对风险和挑战，维护和促进好世界的和平与发展。中国的创新是开放环境下的创新。中国政府一直坚持以全球视野谋划和推动创新，积极融入全球科技创新网络，加强对外创新交流。中以两国创新合作意愿强烈，合作基础深厚。以色列拥有先进的创新体制，形成了人才、理念、技术、资金四位一体的创新生态模式。在电子信息、生物医药、医疗器械、现代农业等领域具有领先优势。中国拥有广阔的市场，已具备一定的科技实力和强大的制造能力，正在为基本实现现代化而努力奋斗。两国在发展阶段、资源禀赋和市场等方面具有较强的互补性，不断深化两国务实合作，符合双方根本利益。2014年，中以创新合作联委会机制建立以来，指导和推动两国在科技、教育、文化、卫生、农业、经贸等各领域创新合作稳步推进。自上次联委会至今，双方合作继续走深、走广。一是各领域合作不断拓展。在科技领域，在纳米科技、计算机科学、医学、农业等领域开展联合研究，启动共建中国中以生命科学联合实验室，通过中以青年创新领袖 中科院国际人才等计划，支持科技人员交流。在教育领域，积极推动中以7+7研究型大学联盟建设，并鼓励联盟外高校借助平台促发展，为双方高校合作营造良好环境。在农业领域，引进乙方先进节水灌溉技术和设施装备，奶牛育种养殖技术，输出中国蔬菜培育生产技术，各自取长补短。在环境领域，加强地下水、环境信息化等环保合作，邀请乙方加入中方和联合国环境署发起筹建的一带一路绿色发展国际联盟。在经济领域，继续推进中乙自贸区谈判，第四轮谈判取得了重要性的进展。在卫生领域，卫生应急、远程医疗、康复医疗、医院管理等合作务实开展。在文化领域，特拉维夫中国文化中心正式揭牌，搭建了中以民心相通的新桥梁。在联委会机制下，新增双方交通运输部门，开辟了新的合作领域。二是各层面统筹协调，形成合力，中央层面加强指导。中乙创新联委会是中国第一个国家层面以创新为主题的对外合作机制。三年来，联委会就加强中乙创新合作，深入交换意见。双方围绕中乙创新合作三年行动计划，谋划长远方向，推动落实共识，取得了诸多成果。政府部门、科研机构、高校和产业界各有分工，产学研深度参与的合作格局初步形成。双方部门协力推动，两国共有20多个部门参与了三年行动计划实施，为深化两国科技创新合作营造环境，搭建平台。部门间围绕卫生应急合作、农业合作研发、青年科学家交流、自然保护合作等签订了27项合作计划和备忘录。地方政府积极参与，中国多个省市积极主动与以色列相关部门开展合作。北京、上海、广东、江苏等省市正在推动对以创新合作平台建设，促进双方创新创业和科技成果的转移转化。三是多渠道、广领域、全方位的合作态势已经形成。中乙常州创业园、创新园、中乙创新合作中心、7+7研究型大学联盟、农业科技城、远程医疗与卫生应急、文化创意产业、知识产权保护等重点合作任务取得了一系列阶段性突破成果。中乙常州创业创新园已进驻以色列各类企业81家，涉及科技、教育、文化、医疗、旅游等多个领域。中乙创新合作中心已举办以色列高新技术中国巡回展、中乙创新创业大赛等活动，累计促进两国2700家企业的对接交流。中医远程医疗项目现已推广到江苏、四川等地的 四家医院，服务覆盖全国20余个城市，用户数千余人。当前，新一轮科技革命和产业变革正在重构全球创新版图，重塑全球经济结构，科技创新活动不断突破地域、组织、技术的界限，创新能力竞争在综合国力竞争中的地位日益重要，各国都在加快科技创新的部署。面向未来，中方愿与乙方携手发挥创新对推动经济社会发展、应对全球挑战的重要作用，共同建设持久和平、普遍安全、共同繁荣、开放包容、清洁美丽的世界。今年是以色列建国70周年，明年我们也将迎来新中国成立70周年。中以创新合作的前景无限广阔，对此我们充满信心。这信心来自于中以之间广泛的共同利益，来自于两国人民的共同意愿。双方应以本次会议为契机，推动中以创新全面活动伙伴关系再上新台阶。谢谢大家。
Thank you very much, Vice President Wang. And now, at this time, we would like to invite Prime Minister Netanyahu and Vice President Wang to actually launch the fourth JCIC meeting and strike together the Chinese traditional gong as it comes in. So, Yi Er San. Thank you very much, Prime Minister Netanyahu and Vice President Wang, and the gong that actually worked. At this time, we would like to thank our friends and colleagues, the representatives of the media. Thank you very much.